Welcome back. This is Freed's, author of My Burnt Orange, and just wanted to welcome you back to the second installment of popular accompaniments for Sadza, Southern African style. And this video, I'm very, very, very excited to present my own Biltong stew. You will love it. It is to die for. It leaves me speechless. That's all I can say. So I hope you make notes, because you know you're going to want to try this. One tip I would like to add: you don't need to add any salt or chicken stock like I did, because the biltong is full of flavor. But let me not say too much. Why don't you go on ahead and enjoy the show? Bye. All right, guys, I am on to the next leg of my mission. So you can see I'm making my sadza. It's quartering nicely, as you can see. Tonight I've decided to make a biltong stew. So I got myself 300 grams of biltong today. I'll write more about what biltong is, but it's basically, you know, Southern Africa's cured meat, you know. You do prosciutto in Italy, and we do biltong. That's how we like it, baby. Got one onion, two tomatoes, some tomato puree, cayenne pepper. Wow, sizzling. Sizzling. Peanut butter. And this is my ginger garlic paste, homemade. I've got some chicken stock just in case we need it, and my muriwo. I got sweetheart cabbage that I'm gonna make. I'll reserve some of the onion for that and just saute it, just boil it, saute it, you know, very simple. That's my butternut that I made earlier. All right, so I'm gonna start, and now in this household, this is a reduced fat household, so anytime I use oil, you know, I measure it, and you know, I'm just using some extra virgin olive oil. Alright, so I'm just going to measure a couple of tablespoons, and literally, you know, this is the tool I use. I literally measure every bit, so 2 tablespoons, it's fine. 3, you know, is more than enough. Okay, so, and in it goes. Alright, so we've got that. It is not a lot, just enough. And this is completely unrehearsed. And, you know, basically this is me. This is how I cook. I just cook what I feel like and just throw things in the pot. Whether or not it comes together, you know, I don't know, but here goes nothing. Alright. I'm going to put in my onions, and remember, I'm reserving some for my muriwo. Don't you just love how I mix up all sorts of languages? You know, like they're one. It's, well, that's just me. That's a combination of all my experiences. So let's put in my onion, and I'll put in some ginger garlic paste. You know, put in as much as you like. Don't feel very much like ginger lately. I mean, or garlic. So you're not putting in too much, but there we have it. Let me just saute that for a little bit. And our biltong. Let's take a closer look. I bought peri peri biltong. I don't usually buy this much, but you know, this South African shop in Charing Cross had a special today. You know, buy 200 grams and get 100 grams free. So that's how I end up with 300 grams of Biltong. And I mean, I think, should I use it all? You know what, we'll see how we go. I might keep some for risotto, but you know what, this Biltong is really chunky. You know, so I think it suits this meal better than risotto. You know, for risotto, you'd probably want the finely sliced Biltong. But, yeah. Alright, so my onions and garlic have sautéed a little bit. They're releasing this wonderful fragrance. I'm just going to throw in the Biltong. You know, just to cook it a little bit. I mean, like, it is cured meat. But, you know, you want to get it cooked just a little bit. Wow, it's looking lovely. Right, unfortunately, I forgot to put on the high heat, so just bear with me. And, yes, it's quiet because I put the baby down, but you'll be hearing from her soon enough, believe me. Right, and because I multitask, I don't have much time. I'm just going to get the Murio up and running as well at the same time. I mean, that's how we do things. Alright, so, you know what, it's just steamed in a bit of water. Very simple, you know, straight to the point. You know, there are different ways of making Murio, but I thought because I've made so many different things tonight, I am just going to keep it simple. Alright, you know, it's not very exciting, is it? But, you know, I'm going to make it simple, and then put a bit of butter in it, just to give it some taste. Might put in a bit of the chicken stock, just to give it some flavor. But, you know, put that in the sink, and I will not be showing you my sink, of course, because it's, it's not looking its best. Alright, I think that is looking good. That's a good time to add your tomato paste. You know, I'd say, I mean, I just measure by eye, but, you know, I'd say depending on how tomatoey you like it, 2 tablespoons is plenty, so between 1 and 2 tablespoons is more than enough. And what I should have done is, I should have added it much earlier, because my mom always tells me, with tomato paste, you want to add it into, you know, your dish as early as possible, because it, you know, so that you can cook off that raw and pungent tomato paste smell. Okay. So I'm doing that, just add a bit of chicken stock to the Murio, and you know, just cover it and let it, you know, cook on a low heat. Now, I didn't really work out in my head what I would do first, but I think I will add the peanut butter first. So I'm going to add a couple of tablespoons of peanut butter. I love peanut butter. Alright, there we go. It's a bit tricky doing this with one hand, guys. Just bear with me. Just stir that in. One over, but yeah, you wanna let that melt and sort of work into the meat. Oh, it smells lovely. Actually, it smells, you know what it actually smells like? In Ghana, we've got this street food called chichinga, and it is to die for. So it smells like chichinga, and it makes me wonder whether there's actually peanut or groundnuts in the chichinga spice. I have to do some research on it, but it smells divine. Oh, and it's looking good. All right, so now I'm gonna add my tomatoes. And I'm using fresh tomatoes. So I think for this meal, you know, fresh works best. Because there's so much, you didn't just see that, did you? Oh well, it's my kitchen. But fresh works well with this. So yeah, stir it around. And I like to let the tomato break down a little bit before adding the chicken stock. So I'll just let it do that. And we'll be back in 5 minutes. I'm back, and what I did, you know, it was only about 5 minutes. The tomato broke down. I added in, you know, just a bit of stock because I don't want it too saucy. And just look at it. This sauce could not have turned out better. I mean, just look at it. The muri was done. Look at that. The satsa's done. Wow. And the pumpkin. The pumpkin is all done. So I'm going to have a feast tonight, y'all. And there was one thing I thought. Biltong has got a lot of fat, so... And so has peanut butter, so you probably can manage on just 1 tablespoon of olive oil, you know, especially that we've put butter in the muriwo and the butternut, but it's time to taste test. And oh yeah, whilst you were gone, I put in a lot of cayenne pepper, because I am Miss Spicy. Alright, so here's my sauce. I don't need to say nothing. It's good. Bon appetit. Wow.